Let's go.
Been a while.
The dog pound is barking here
Big
in
game.
Cleveland Browns Stadium. We're glad you could join us for our first broadcast of the year. Today's matchup looks like it'll be a great battle. Well, the teams are out on the field, the crowd in full throat as we get this new season started with the kickoff. From the 4-yard line.
Oh. What?
Excellent field position as they start this drive. Anticipates having a big game today, John. You could tell when we sat down with him yesterday just how confident he is.
Yeah, he's feeling good, and he's getting the ball during key play. He's a great player, and he's thinking end zone every time he touches a ball.
The bats are lined up in an eye. Steps up into the pocket.
Yo, Willie.
With Willie McGinnis coming off the end, you have a speedy guy who can get into the backfield and cause some problems for the quarterback.
Ball on the 23-yard line. Press coverage on the outside.
Blue Dan, Blue Dan.
Cleveland comes out in a dive back. Setting up play action. Pressure coming.
This team's a little easy. Run all that. Okay.
Two straight sacks, John.
Yeah, they did a good job of getting upfield and taking them down.
And they'll face a long third down here. Corners are moving up to press the receivers. The Browns come out in a dime package. They're coming with the blitz. Pumps once. Closing in. Going long.
Yes. Good defense.
First step, he can explode through the hole, but he needs a line to create that little crease or cutback lane to break free.
Defense, get ready.
They line up in the I formation. Hand it off. Clark is there for the tackles.
They might not be busting off big game, but those linemen are really working hard down there.
Ball on their own 21.
Ball on the 21-yard line.
Play hard and fast, baby.
The defense lines up in the nickel.
Oh, shit, couldn't get it over there.
When you talk about ball control and time of possession, that's not what you want to see.
Sastadil is ready to pump this one away. Holm is back to receive this kick. From the 31.
46-yard punt. Return to the gain of 2 yards.
It's first and ten.
Start the drive at the 33-yard line. First and ten.
Here we come. That's right.
The Browns come out in a nickel package. Going to the air on first down. Throws it. And the catch is made. Thompson is there for the tackle at the 38. Roethlisberger will be looking at second down now after that pass picks up 5 yards.
Second and five. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Under 10, 10.
Out of the I formation.
They soft, man.
He tucks it away. Setting up play action.
Ooh. With the pass. Another one.
Drops the interception. Ward was the one they were trying to get the ball to. But had the coverage on the play.
Third and five.
I'm just heating them up here.
Hold the line.
the motion man. Gets the pass off. And it's complete. Jones comes up to make the play at the 48. Excellent recognition by the receiver, reading the coverage and adjusting his route accordingly.
Option routes are receiving routes designed to take advantage of the coverage. It's up to both the receiver and the quarterback to make the same read. If the receiver reads zone, but the quarterback reads man, you can see passes going right to defenders.
And he gets the delayed handoff. McGinnis is there for the tackle at the 48-yard line. Parker is the injured player on the field. He'll be coming out for this next play, so we'll find out what the story is. Second and six.
Ball on the 48-yard line.
Here we go, baby.
The Browns come out in a nickel pack. Drops back. Surveying the field. He'll keep it. Runs through the tackle. Comes up to make the play at the 26-yard line. And it's the quarterback himself able to pick up a big first down.
Here's the thing. If you give him any type of lane or gap to run through, he's going to take it, and he's usually going to take it for a big gain.
To the right.
There we go.
He's brought down behind the line for a short loss.
When you run a play to the outside, at least one offensive lineman is pulling, and a wide receiver has to block down.
And 12.
And that one, neither one did their job very well.
Making some changes along the defensive front.
Another drop. They got good blocks.
The 10. Great defense. And he is bumped out of bounds at the 4. Looks to be shaken up after that play, and we'll get you a report from the sideline when we get the information.
Perfect play call there.
From the goal line now. They threw a pick the last time they had the ball inside the 20. Hand it off. Is there for the tackle at the 2-yard line. First and goal, they can't get into the end zone. Williams returns to the game after being shaken up earlier. In regard to the injury, they have decided to keep him on the sideline at least for now, and his return appears to be doubtful. Nice play.
Why didn't he even drop more? I read it. It was too close to the line.
Makes this play work is a fake to the back. And then with that, it gets a receiver that half step he needs to make the catch.
The extra point attempt is good.
They did everything they had to on that one. And the end result is a trip across the goal line and a TD on the board.
Reed in to kick this one off. From the 4.
Oh.
Now it's their turn to do something on offense. They're down by a touchdown early. But these guys have the kind of offense that can score any time they have the ball.
The Browns will start the drive at the 35-yard line. First and 10.
There we go. Don't make a play.
Harrison, the lone back, on the carry. Townsend is there on the stop.
This team's always trying to get a good mix of run and pass plays.
And he picks up about 4. It's second down and 6 to go. Lewis lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Hand it off. Tyson is there for the tackle. It appears they've gotten someone for holding.
Didn't make.
On the offense. Number 6, Eden.
Williams held him up.
The rule on the hold is you can't let your hands go to the outside of the body. If your hands do move outside, then you have to move them back in as soon as you can, or you'll get called for holding.
Under pressure, on the move. Incomplete. Pretty good coverage.
As was I. Exciting, exciting win.
In front of him to scramble out of the pocket and pick up a few yards. Maybe he should have done that.
With the pass.
And we're punting again.
At the 38-yard line, John, he'll be well short of the first down.
Now here's the thing.
The defense had all the guys covered. Well, I mean, I think they have a good chance to beat the Steelers this week.
And he just couldn't do it.
So they line up to punt after going 3-and-out.
Steelers have got nothing on offense.
From the 16. Holmes returns this one to
not a damn thing.
Shifting some personnel up front. The Steelers line up in the bunch formation. It's a blitz. Throws it. Wide receiver has it. Baxter is there on the stop at the 25. Not a whole lot on that one.
That's what bringing a blitz will do. It'll force you to make the throw before you want to. They're just lucky he didn't throw it to the other team.
And we're ready to start the second quarter.
Second and 8. Ball on the 25-yard
line. I don't have much on offense in this game either, though. But yeah.
They're making some changes up front.
Brutal for this first season.
With the carry. Davis comes up to make the play at the 35-yard line. Great run there. That'll be a first down.
He really ran well there. He gets some great blocks, and he has patience as he picks up the first down.
With the throw, and he hits his target. The 20,
okay.
The 10. A lot of room to work with. Touchdown, Steelers.
When you get this kind of execution, you got a great chance of making a big play. Watch it here as everyone takes care of their assignment. The pass is thrown where the receiver can make the best play in the ball, and it's 6 points.
The extra point attempt is good. Excellent possession there, John, capped off by the touchdown. And right now they've given themselves a little room for error.
They're moving the ball out there pretty easily. Every time I see these guys play, I'm very impressed by the players they have, especially on offense. But the thing that impresses me most is the coaching staff. They're always very well prepared. They do a good job of calling plays, and the plays that are designed to take advantage of the other team.
All right, let's try to move the ball.
If they want to make this a game, they have to buckle down, avoid mistakes, and work hard to dig themselves out of this hole.
Have to readjust to using the vision cone again. It's not hard to use, but
it
does take some use getting used to.
To make the play at the 30-yard line.
Now they got to keep going at it. They can get that defense tired and on its heels. These games will get longer and bigger as the game goes on.
30-yard line.
Put in this direction.
Hey, a first down.
He's there on the stop at the 34-yard line.
That was a good job by the back who just saw the hole, and boom, he hit it right in there for a few yards, and he got the chain gang moving.
Quinn using split back.
They have a bunch of guys in this defense that can really get after their quarterback. With their speed and quickness, they can get around the blockers and put a lot of pressure on the signal caller.
Following the sack, it's second and long. The Steelers come out in a dime package. With the throw, gets his hand on it. Good push by the defensive line, forcing the incomplete pass.
He hung in there. He didn't really have the time that he needed to make the play. The quarterback has to know who his outlet guy is and get the ball to him when he feels that pressure coming.
The Browns line up in a five-receiver set this time. And he hits his target. Polamalu is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 35-yard line.
That's a poorly planned play. You have to know that you have to get past the first down marker on third down. Anything less has to be a failure.
Holmes sets up, waiting for the punt. He's waving for the fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 20-yard line.
First and 10.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
Let's go now.
Making some changes along the defensive front. Davenport, the long back.
Go.
Down behind.
fool anybody with that play call. The defense knew what was coming, and they shut that thing down quickly.
Second and long. In motion. Hand it off to the back. Flips the tackle.
They're going to spot this one at the 23. So that tackle now gives him four.
Davenport
picks up some tough yards there.
Third and seven. Ball on the 23-yard line.
The Browns come out on a nickel package.
The rushes are there we go.
This pass is incomplete. And the receiver is not able to make the adjustment to the underthrown ball.
Was his intended target.
Very solid defensive effort to force the three and out. The 30.
Now you start to look around and you figure, who are the go-to guys? The guys who can respond and get this game close again.
I don't think my team has any go-to guys right now. Maybe Braylon Edwards.
Out of the I formation. Receives the handoff. Barrier is there on the stop at the 40-yard line. It's second down and six to go.
Tucks it away. Bart is there for the tackle at the 46-yard line. And that gain will get them a fresh set of downs.
It was a great run. He saw his blockers create some room for him, and he accelerated right through the hole.
Harrison, the lone setback.
Oh, Brady. Seriously.
Incomplete pass.
He just flicked his wrist and the ball just took off. He just needed to take a little bit off of that one. And it could have gone for a big play.
Was the intended receiver.
Yeah, I'd love to see the Diamondbacks make and win the World Series again.
Lewis lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Hands it off. Harrison is there on the stop at the 44-yard line.
You talk about a sense of knowing where a play is heading. That's just great instinct.
Third and long. And here's a look at each team's success on third down so far. They'll go from the shotgun.
Wow, why didn't he run it up the sideline? I thought he was going to.
I really like the way these guys get after the quarterback.
I thought he was going to cut it up.
Guys out there that have non-stop motor. They push to the inside, they rush to the outside, and they really do a good job applying pressure, forcing the quarterback to throw it before he wants to.
This one goes out of bounds. They'd like
throwing
to add
baseball.
A few more points to this lead, but we'll need to do a good job with clock management. Ball on their own 26.
Ball on the 26-yard line.
Roethlisberger back in the shotgun. He's going to run. Wright comes up to make the play at the 39. Dropping back to pass on first down with the throw. Thrown behind but caught. Bodden is there on the stop at the 43-yard line. You can't draw it up any better than that. Textbook first down. So after that nice catch and run, here's a look at his stats. The Browns come out in a dime package. Gets rid of it. He was tipped. Roethlisberger did a good job reading the coverage, but couldn't get it there.
Second and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Drops back. Throwing. Gary Baxter.
Go, Gary.
The quarterback never even looked for any of his other options.
The offense gets ready to go following the interception. Only one man in the backfield. Closing in.
I can't even throw.
It's broken up.
And he has a great feel for defending the pass. He always seems to be in great position to make a play in the ball.
Will, there we go.
Harris, the lone back. With the pass. Barr comes up to make the play at the 33. Quinn throws that pass for a gain of 7.
Third and 4.
It's third down and 4 to go. Five wide receivers. Steps up. Under pressure. He'll run this one. McFadden is there on the stop at the 38-yard line.
Come on! Regular. From the start.
They're coming with the blitz. With the throw, gets his hand on it.
He has to do a better job of looking off the coverage before he makes a throw like that.
Johnson was the one they were trying to get the ball to.
Ball on the 38-yard line.
Dropping back. Rolls right. Long throw. It's batted away.
He has a knack for making a big play. That was another one right there.
Card was his intended target.
Third and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Go make a play. Defense, get ready.
The Browns line up in the bunch formation. Gets the pass off. Right on target to the wide receiver. He gets the pass to his receiver, who will come up just short of the first down.
Never sure why a quarterback chooses that pass instead of one deeper downfield on that third down situation.
Fourth and about 2. Keep the offense on the field here. Aggressive play call. Looking to convert through the.
No, how did we not block him?
Look here, this is not what a quarterback is supposed to do on fourth down. It's your last shot. You're going for it. At least throw it up there and give your guy a shot. A sack is definitely not what you're looking for here.
Run.
With the throw.
Oh.
And he makes the grab. Baxter is there on the stop at the 17-yard line.
You always have to make sure this guy's covered. Heck, he can put up these kind of numbers even if he does have a guy on him.
They're in the red zone.
Ball on the 17-yard line.
Let's go, boys!
So with the ball in the red zone, they have a very good chance of extending that lead. Blitzes on. Throwing.
Oh, where are we?
Steelers.
Watch this catch by the tight end. I always say the tight end is always more of a threat in the red zone. He's a big target, and his skills sometimes cause matchup problems for the defense.
The extra point attempt is good. And so they're handed great field position and cash in.
Yeah, when you give this team field position like that, you can practically take a touchdown to the bank.
Going with the squib kick. A mistake by the kicker on that one.
The team with the most discipline is a team that doesn't commit stupid penalties. And they're the team that usually executes better.
And this should be the last play of the half. The Browns line up in the bunch formation. Fires this one deep. What a catch. This one will be spotted at the 38. That's 3 tackles so far for him today. Ball on the 38-yard line. The Steelers come out in a nickel package. They'll pass on first down.
rolls out to his left. He threw it out of the end zone. Darn it.
So after the first two quarters of play,
we're ready to begin the
Reed will be kicking off. This one is handled by number 11. The Browns need to run quickly as they start this drive.
Instincts are wrong.
The Browns will start the drive at the 23-yard line. First and 10.
Hey, let's go one deep.
Lewis is the deep back. Handed off to the back. Hart is there for the tackle at the 27-yard line.
The best backs in the league average 4 to 5 yards a carry. But there are a lot of things that go into a successful running game. You got to have good play calling, good blocking up front, and a back that can take advantage when he sees the opening.
Gives the ball off.
Oh.
Harrison is there on
the making every play.
At the 27.
When your running game is struggling, you have to start looking for offense from some of your other players. They can loosen it up a little with a few passes. It should open up those running lanes again. This team has to start converting on third down if they're going to be successful.
And this pass is puts it on the ground. The Steelers scoop up the ball. Came loose and the defense was right there to pick it up. So what we're looking for here is whether one of his knees hit the ground before the ball came out.
And sometimes it's hard for the official because there can be a whole bunch of bodies around the ball carrier. He can't get a good enough view to overturn it.
Ball on their own 33.
Ball on the 33-yard line.
Hey, watch the ball.
Only one man in the backfield. They give it to the halfback. Hart comes up to make the play at the 40.
A successful running attack requires good blocking up front to be effective.
Ball on their own 40.
Ball on the 40-yard line.
Solo! Solo!
Set!
Come on!
Here comes the blitz. Going long. It was tipped.
That's just the kind of play they've come to expect from him. He always seems to make the big play just when they need him to.
Harrison was the intended receiver on that play.
I think this defense looks forward to these third down situations because they've been stopping him today.
About a 5-yard pickup for the first down.
The defense was taken out of their game plan on that play. No one was able to get away from their block until it was too late.
Lewis, the deep man, aimed it off to the back. Foot is there on the stop at the 44. No gain on that play as the linebacker slipped in almost unnoticed.
Yeah, he did a great job getting in there. He was looking for the run before they even snapped the ball.
Hands it off. Spins away from the tackle. Higgins is there for the tackle at the 48-yard line. Lewis busted through for a few tough yards. Here's a look at the third down success rate of each team. The offense has had trouble moving the sticks on third down so far. Throwing. Higgins makes the play at the 45.
Let's go now.
Hand it off to the back. Barrier comes up to make the play at the 39. Lewis runs it through the middle, a gain of about 6. 3 minutes remaining in the quarter.
On the 39-yard line.
Here we go, baby. Everything you got. 58.
They give it to the halfback. Foot is there for the tackle at the 37.
Gain of 2.
He was looking for a place to run, but all those places were filled up with guys waiting to tackle him.
Ball on the 37-yard line.
Here on third and short with the pass, and he makes the grab. Stiff arm to the ground. That was a good adjustment by the receiver.
All right.
The main coverage and finds open space.
The thing with these option routes is everyone has to make their read quickly and make their adjustments quickly. Running option routes and running them effectively takes a lot of repetition and practice.
Gets it off to the back. Carr comes up to make the play at the 18.
He's looked pretty good so far. It's going to be up to the defensive coordinator to make some adjustment and find a way to slow him down.
They're blitzing with the throw. McFadden is there for the tackle at the 11. Another first down, this time through the air.
And if they're not just picking up first downs, they're picking up first downs on third down, which is even more impressive.
They'll go from the I formation. They give it to the halfback, refusing to go down.
Kill Jamal.
Spot this one at the 2 yard line. He put the hit on him, and he now has 7 tackles.
You know what this does? It keeps one defense on the field. And it doesn't let them get the right personnel in there sometimes.
Hands it off.
He's in.
Harrison comes up to make the play at the 1. They don't deviate at all from the last play call as they keep it on the ground. 1 more yard into touchdown. Quinn sends a man in motion. Trying to sneak. Polamalu is there for the tackle at the 1 yard line. You could tell by the blocking that that was a designed quarterback run, and it worked well enough for a first down. The defense lines up in the next one. Gets rid of it. No completion there.
And you got to wonder what happened. It looked like a pretty good throw, but it bounced right off his hands. One thing's for sure, you don't often get that wide open.
It's second and goal at the 1.
Fucking unbelievable.
It's loose.
Oh no.
Scoop up the fumble.
What?
Close it up on the sack.
And the thing.
What?
This might be a good challenge by the fumble.
The call on the field is questionable. They're going to review it, and this one might get reversed.
And we'll take a few looks to determine whether the ball came out before the knee was down.
The key thing here is that the ball started to come out before his knee was down.
Deep in their own territory. The Steelers line up in the bunch formation.
Here we go.
They'll bring the blitz.
Oh, come on.
Target to the wide receiver. The
what the fuck, guys?
At the 45-yard line.
Ben Roethlisberger was a real deal right off the bat. He throws the ball all over the lot, not just check down.
Here we go, baby.
Making some changes along the defensive front. Davenport, the deep man.
Do something.
They're coming with the blitz. Johnson makes the catch. Baxter is there on the stop at the 34-yard line. You saw the whole field was able to stand back there and find the open man.
You know, when a defense is sending extra rushers at the quarterback, it takes a lot of poise to get the ball out of there with any accuracy.
The rushers on with the throw. The 10, 5. Is there for the tackle. As the 1. Big gain on that play, 32 yards. And it'll be a first and goal. 1 more yard for the touchdown.
Let's go. Not today. Watch the snap now.
Their last red zone trip resulted in a touchdown.
Watch your eyes. Will. Let's go now.
Pressure.
That's the kind of thing you got to do. You got to find a way to put the pressure on and disrupt his timing in the pocket.
It's second and goal at the 6.
Let's go. Be
give it to the halfback. Sean Jones stops him dead at the 5. So at the end of the third quarter, the score is 21-0. Steelers. The teams are set for the fourth quarter of play. They need 5 yards for a touchdown.
It's on. Get it started. Danny. Go make a play.
The backs are lined up in an eye. Hand it off to the back. Davis comes up to make the play at the 3. Nothing doing on that running play, so they'll probably send in the kicker.
I think so. When you've got the lead, you don't have to try anything fancy. You just tack on the 3 and put the game in your defense's hands.
Mike Vanderjagt comes in to attempt a 21-yard field goal. The attempt is good. The Steelers have it all working now as they continue to expand their lead. Jeffrey looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. From the 3-yard line.
They need one quick score and then some more.
On the return.
The ball on their own 25.
The drive at the 25-yard line. First and 10.
Watch out. You can't
say Harrison, the lone back. Pass play here on first down. Looking for something long. He's there for the catch.
Put it up there.
Comes up to make the play at the 39.
I can do it, baby. Yeah, it's on. Not today.
I'll come through, baby.
He'll pass on first down. Throws it. He has it. Shea Townsend brought him down for his third tackle.
Oh my God.
If you're the offense, you hate to see things like that happen. What happens if they don't get it now? This could really come back to haunt.
Jurevicius was the one they were trying to get the ball to.
Jurevicius is there to do.
They line up in the I formation. Hand it off.
Are you kidding me?
There on the stop at the 2-yard line. 9-yard gain
on the play.
They need 2 yards to get it in the end zone. Here are the numbers when it comes to third down conversion. The defense has had difficulty stopping
Why?
Play man-to-man that well, it limits a quarterback's options. And it'll result in a sack sometime.
Can't block.
Fourth and six.
We can't block.
This is a situation where they just have to go for it.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
This pass is incomplete. Down by this much here in the fourth, they had no choice but to go for it.
Well, they're at the point of the game where they have to try something. Heck, next time maybe you try something else, but you can understand why they want to go for it here.
They'll take over at the 6-yard line. First and 10.
Knock him out! Throw right. Get me going.
Right.
Sit.
Hand it off to the fullback. Jones is there for the tackle.
On the carry.
And the 16. He is a big offensive force.
You know, this guy's a load to bring down. Defense has had a tough time wrapping up those big old tree trunks he has for legs.
Changing things up along the defensive front. They'll go from the I formation.
Watch the snap now. Get the flag going. Ranger.
Watch out. On the pull. Williams is there on the stop at the 18. Solid gain on the draw, and they convert for a first down.
He didn't get a huge chunk of yards, but he got past the marker, and that'll bring up a fresh set of down.
Strong, strong, two guys. Let's go. Tampa.
Yeah, let's go, baby.
Come on. From the start, from the start. Here we go. Don't stop, don't stop that motor. Let's do our thing, let's do our thing. Under 10, 10.
To carry it, Jackson is there for the tackle at the 19.
1 yard gain on the play.
Davis stops the clock there. Ball on their own 19.
Ball on the 19-yard line.
Here we come. It's showtime, baby. Clear, clear. Hey, watch that screen. Over swing right.
He takes the delayed handoff. Jackson is there on the stop at the 21-yard line. Ryder looks to be shaken up after that play, and we'll get you a report from the sideline when we get the information. Ball on their own 21.
Ball on the 21-yard line.
Play football.
A
I'm coming through, baby.
Set.
Keep the throttle down.
All right, here we go.
Off to the back. Smith comes up to make the play at the 23.
Gain of two on the play.
Oh, boy.
We'll come in now to punt it away. Number 11. Looks like he's ready for the return. From the 32-yard line. After a short return, he's brought down at the 42-yard line. Ball on their own 42.
At the 42-yard line. First and 10.
Here we go. So we're going to take it.
Here they come with the throw. James Farrier is the man to bring him down. That's his third tackle. Win. Felt the pressure. Got rid of it quickly.
Hey, that's exactly the kind of thing you want to do when you're under heavy pressure. Hit a hot read and maybe get a couple yards out of it.
We've just gotten word that he's injured his foot, although it's not serious. His return is listed as questionable. Dropping back, gets the pass over.
Ow.
Receiver has it. McFadden comes up to make the play at the 49-yard line. Third down and three coming up.
Ball on the 49-yard line.
Harrison, the lone back, drops back, throwing. Shea Townsend picks it up. The 30, the 20, the 10, 5, touchdown, Steelers. He returns the interception for 6 points here in the final quarter. Vanderjagt comes in to attempt the point after. The point after is good. The Steelers continue to increase their lead. As we take a look at a success returning kicks, we get ready for the kickoff.
Bloom, back to return.
Decent kick, we should have a return. This one is handled by number 11.
It sure doesn't look like they're going to be able to come back in this one. It's an issue of pride. They want to prove that they're better than they've played so far.
The Browns all on their own 28.
Drive at the 28-yard line. First and 10.
He'll pass on first down. Looking deep to the right.
Everything's up the field.
Knocks it away.
They're going to make the quarterback keep throwing because it's the only way that they have a shot at coming back.
Harrison, the lone back. Fires this one deep. It's caught. The 40, the 30. Taylor is there for the tackle.
He's one of the most dangerous receivers. I like to get the ball in his hands because he can break a long one at any time.
5 wide receivers. Looking long down the right side of the field.
Finally.
And grabs it.
The receiver just picked his way through the coverage, finding a little room. And he threw a strike to him for the score.
Dawson comes in for the extra point. The point after is good. The Browns still with a huge deficit to overcome. Well, they need the ball back and they need points, so they're lining up for the onside kick. Here's the onside kick. They recover.
This is one of those situations where they're playing for respect. The game really hasn't gone the way they thought it would, but they have a lot of pride in their team. I'd expect to see them keep fighting until that final whistle.
37-yard line. First and 10.
Not today.
The Browns line up in a 5-receiver set this time. with the throw, and it's caught. He'll knock him out of bounds at the 42. Wilson picks up about six after that catch. Ball on their own 42.
Ball on the 42-yard line.
Watch the snap now.
Quinn using split backs.
Fuck.
Coming.
Fuck.
The big man gets in there for a big sack.
He's got a great combination of size and move. He won't be winning any races. He's good at getting after the quarterback. And let me tell you, you never want him to be the guy falling on top of you.
Gets rid of it. This one falls incomplete. Cleveland falters again on third down, John.
And you know something? This is why teams lose games. They do some things right, but then when they need the big play to help win a game, they fall apart.
I don't think they have a choice. They have to go for it. Rolling out to his left.
Hey, we drop every pass, dude. What the fuck?
And they can't convert on fourth down, John. I'd say the game is over right now.
Yeah, this game has been a lopsided affair. That play summed up their problems throughout the last three quarters.
And there's the kneel down by the quarterback.
Fuck it.
Let's go. Keep it up. Hey, let's go one deep.
They soft, man.
Here we go. Three shoot. Defense, get ready. Hot. Clear. Clear. Hot.
This game reaches its conclusion with the final score, Pittsburgh 31.
The Steelers 7. 31. The Browns 7. Thank you for attending today's ball. Please drive home safely.
That was terrible. Fix Tim Carter real quick. I don't know why they made him this white. I can't. This guy doesn't look like that at all. Like to think we can be a little bit more competitive against the Bengals. I don't know though. If I could.
Whoa. Both teams eager to get today's action started, so let's go to the field. Dawson's in to kick this one off.
Start the game. Hold back deep to return.
He got all of that one. From the 2-yard line. Ready to go on offense for the first time. On a day like today, John, with rain expected throughout the day, do you think one team has the advantage over the other?
No, I really don't. The field is already muddy. It's just going to get sloppier as the game wears on. It's going to be tough for both of these offenses to hold on to the ball.
Jones comes up to make the play at the 30.
When your offensive line is getting a good push up front, it's a lot easier to pick up yardage on the ground.
Making some changes along the defensive front.
Come on! Stay focused up! We're talking about green! Hey, watch that screen!
They're coming with the blitz.
Oh, you were there.
Pope is there on the stop. Chad Johnson fails his quarterback out by making a spectacular catch.
Yep, that was an unbelievable catch. That took the ability to block out the entire field and focus on bringing him in.
Slight change in the defensive alignment. Johnson, the lone setback. They go with a draw. Schmidt gets right in there and brings him down. So on the draw, he can't get free from the defensive lineman.
Yeah, he shedded his blocker. He moved in for the stop behind the line.
Second and long coming up here.
Get it up. Yes, on.
Out of the I formation. The blitz is on. Rowing.
Yep, thank you.
Room to run. Palmer has that one picked off.
The ball and the defender and the receiver all got there at the same time.
So after the interception, now it's first and 10. Cincinnati goes with a four-man front. Handoff off to the tailback. Miller is there on the stop. Lewis rumbles forward for a gain of four. Ball on the 37-yard line.
Rain, we just want them to get nice and familiar with our run game here.
The Bengals with a four-man front. He hands it off. Miller is there for the tackle at the 34.
When you run the ball in the first half, you're trying to keep the defense on it. But if you're only getting gains like that in the second half, then it puts more pressure on your passing game.
Gain of three.
Third
down here. They have to get it to the 31-yard line to convert. The Bengals come out in a 4-3. Hand off to the tailback. Spotted at the 29-yard line.
And that's Matt Lewis is on the team here.
So he picks up about five on that run, moving the chains in the process.
Power run game.
Great job there of blocking the backside pursuit, which helped him get the first down.
Number 93 is there on the stop at the 25-yard line.
This is a spot where you want to show the defense that they have to respect the running game.
Gain of four. All on the 25-yard line.
All on the 25-yard line.
Here we go, baby.
Harrison, the lone setback. On the goal, they'll spot this one at the 22-yard line. It's the fourth stop he's made today.
This team's always trying to get a good mix of run and pass plays.
Ball on the 22-yard line.
Walker in the backfield. Hands it off to the back. Number 93 makes the stop before the first down is reached. The offense stalls, but they do have a chance to put 3 points on the board. Fourth down coming up, and they need about two.
So we're going to take it. Walk around.
Silver, 36.
So instead of attempting the field goal, they're going to go for it.
He missed them.
Defense comes up big on a very interesting
here
in the first half.
Yeah, you really have to question the decision making here. You're saying that you're not going to trust your special team, but now you put all the pressure on your defense.
The defense is shifting. Only one man in the backfield.
Bring it up.
On the delay. Spinsley. Jackson is there on the stop at the 20. They wanted to pound it through the middle, but they got pounded for a loss.
I'll tell you, that was a perfect time for these guys to call a blitz. They got in there, filled the gap, and brought down the back for a loss.
Slight change in the defensive alignment. Cleveland comes out in their nickel package. Drops back. Pump fakes. Rowing.
Oh, and completed.
The 40.
No pressure.
The 20. The 10. Touchdown, Bengals.
Touchdown, Cincinnati.
The receiver ran a perfect route, and he turned around just in time to see the ball and make the catch.
Graham comes in to attempt the point after. The point after is good.
Give some credit to that big offensive line. Those guys are working hard out there, and it's showing on drives like that.
Cincinnati is lined up with the kickoff. Bloom back deep to return.
From the one. Flags are down, and this one appears to be on the offense.
Holding on the receiving team, number 27.
A team has to show discipline and execute properly out there. If they don't, they'll find it's much harder to overcome the other team and get a win.
First and 10.
First and 10.
Hey, let's go one deep. Turn it out in there. Hey, watch that screen.
Hand it off. It's a fumble. What a great strip. This might be a good challenge by the coach.
The call on the field is questionable. They're going to review it, and this one might get reversed.
The coach is hoping to get it right here because that could be a big lift to the team.
What the official will be looking for here is to see if the knee is down. It's tough to say without replay. It won't be easy.
First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Cincinnati goes with a four-man front. They give it to the halfback. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss. No gain on that play as the linebacker slipped in almost unnoticed.
Yeah, he did a great job getting in there. He was looking for the run before they even snapped the ball.
Using split back. A little misdirection. Ball is there on the stop at the 30.
This is one of those games where you just keep running it at him. 4 yards here, 5 yards there, loosen them up, and then wham. You knock them out late in the game with that long touchdown run.
Wham, using split back. Throwing. Hits the fullback. They'll spot this one at the 43. The tackle is his fifth of the game. The fullback was on the receiving end.
And he's a good option coming out of the backfield. He can do a lot more than just block. He can catch it out of the backfield, carry it, and heck, I've even seen him throw it once or twice.
Miles ahead. It's a fumble. The Browns are there to pick up the
ball. Oh,
I'm guessing this is a block in the back. Let's see what the call is.
Number 73.
We cannot get any momentum.
So it'll be first and long here after the penalty. The Bengals come out of a nickel pack. He tucks it away. Gathers, comes up to make the play at the 39. They don't deviate at all from the last play call as they keep it on the ground.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
They'll go from the I formation, dropping back, throwing.
Jesus Christ, Jurevicius. Just make it open.
Jurevicius was his intended target.
The intended receiver on the play.
In the second game in a row where he's...
The Bengals come out with three down linemen and seven defensive backs. Throwing
wow.
The run. O'Neal is there on the stop. The defense blitzes the corner, but the quarterback got rid of it quickly for a completion and a first down.
That was a great play because he saw him coming, remained calm, and threw an accurate pass.
Hands it off to the back. Thornton drags the ball carrier down behind the line. Trying to find some room in the middle, but there was no place to go.
He brought some extra guys up on the run blitz. They got penetration, and they shut the play down.
So at the end of one, the score is 7. And we're ready to start the second quarter.
Ball at about midfield.
Ball on the 48-yard line.
Flat 36.
Out of the I formation. Hands it off.
Brown
comes to make the play at the 45. Lewis takes advantage of a little daylight, picks up 3 yards.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
They'll go from the I formation. Pressure coming.
There we go, Joe.
He finds his man. God, he has such a
That's what I need him to do.
Makes it hard for him to be sacked, and it gives the defenders less time to react.
Those plays.
Cincinnati using three linebackers. They give it to the halfback. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss.
On the carry. That was a lack of execution from the offense. When the plan is to take it to the outside, around the corner, you need to pick up some key blocks.
The Bengals, with a four-man front, receives the handoff. Miller comes up to make the play at the 28.
You got to keep going to the run. You never know when there's going to be great blocking ahead of you, allowing for a big one right into the end zone.
Third down, and they'll have to try to get it to the 24-yard line to pick up a first down. They'll go from the I formation. Hand it off.
Come on, Kevin, you can't run play action. I'm out of field goal range.
The offensive line just lost the battle up front on that play. They have to keep their shoulders square, keep their inside foot up, and they're going to get beat again and again.
It's fourth down, 9 yards to go. So instead of taking a shot at a long field goal, they'll try to get a first down. With the throw, he's pushed out at the 21-yard line. Jarvicious was the one they were trying to get the ball to. This is the 15th play of this drive. The Bengals line up in a 4-3. Tucks it away. Jackson comes up to make the play. Lewis rumbles forward for a gain of 4. Getting it to the 11-yard line would net them a first down. The defense lines up in the nickel. They're coming with the blitz. Incomplete. A short pass off the mark, and it's now fourth down.
Better kick it here.
I mean, just can't get big plays.
Dawson comes out, hoping to put points on the scoreboard for the first time. Through the uprights and good.
What they want to do now is to realize they've established some things on offense and to improve upon them the next drive to get a TD rather than a field goal.
From the 3-yard line. Let's see if they can have the same sort of success on this possession that they had on their last. Picking up a lot of yardage through the air on their way to a score. Ball on their own 27. Defensive line shifting around a bit. Only one man in the backfield. With the throw, gets his hand on it. It was the intended receiver on that play. Davis had the coverage on the play.
Second and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line.
Here we go. Here we go, baby. Rock and roll. One of us will make a play.
Looking upfield, number 95 is there on the stop at the 29.
Right now, they need to keep going at the defense with a run. Sooner or later, they'll be able to break one for a big game.
So a pickup of maybe 3. It's third down and 7 to go.
Ball on the 29-yard line.
Dime backs in for this play.
Keep the throttle down.
They're coming with the
play. Let's go.
Under pressure, wrapped up and brought down. Someone gets free.
They had thrown the screen.
One of the advantages of the 3-4 defense. They can always bring that extra rusher. And you don't know where he's
they threw the
from.
Screen. I think they had
it. Or the inside. It could be a linebacker, it could be a safety. And right there, it led to a sack.
Larson is ready to punt this one away. Number 11 is the deep return man. From the 32. Picked up pretty good yardage that time, and he stopped at the 43-yard line. 2 minute warning coming up.
Watch this.
He tucks it away. Nico is there on the stop at the 45.
1 yard gain on the play.
Almost at the 2 minute mark now.
On the 45 yard line.
Out of the I formation. Hand it off. They'll spot this one at the 48. The defensive tackle surged through the line to bring the runner down. 2 minute warning coming up.
Ball on the 48 yard line.
The Bengals line up at a 4-3. Hangs in the pocket. On the move.
Fuck, where is that throw going?
The defense dug in their cleats and held their ground on that series down.
Can't believe that throw.
To go for it, and here's how they've done so far. And rather than punt, they can let the offense have a shot at this fourth down.
Oh!
With the pass, and he steps out of bounds at the 48.
Oh, we were right on it.
The offense turns the ball over on downs.
Sometimes the coach is in a position to gamble. Sometimes they're the hero, and other times they
can be the review.
Dimebacks in for this play. It's a blitz. Throws it. Drops the interception. Kelly was his intended target. Right with the coverage.
Second and 10. Ball on the 48 yard line.
Hold the look.
They need some better blocking out of that offensive front. You have to use your hands, get them out in front of you, keep them inside, maintain leverage and balance that you need to hold those blocks and slow down the pass rush.
Cleveland puts its secondary in better position to stop the pass. Perry, the long back. Pressure.
Oh, what he...
He hits his receiver.
He beat us.
He is there for the tackle at the 40.
Hey, this is where you run those two-minute drills in practice for a situation like this. The only difference is... This isn't the scout team defense.
The fucking tight end. How does he win on that?
Get my cut back.
I'm coming through, baby.
Pressure coming. Throwing. And he hits his target. Oh, he's there on the stop.
Fucking garbage.
And the thing is, he doesn't care how big that window is. With his accuracy, everyone's open.
Palmer with split pass. Pass play here on first down with the pass. And the catch is made. The 10. Touchdown, Bengals.
I'll tell you, this is nice work by both the quarterback and the receiver in this play. Watch it here. He reads the coverage, looks for the best option, and then throws it to him.
The extra point attempt is good.
The thing that most impressed me about that last drive was the offensive line. A strong offensive line is the first and most important component to an effective offense.
Blue, back to return.
From the 4.
Oh. Great blocking, guys.
This is where you want to respond quickly, or this could turn into a battle for field position.
Ball on their own 20.
Start the drive at the 20-yard line. First and 10.
The Bengals with a four-man front. Gets rid of it. Knocked away. Becker was the one they were trying to get the ball to.
The intended receiver on the play. Second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Hey, let's go.
Harrison, the lone back, drops back. Rolls left with the pass. Leading pass to the back. William is there for the tackle at the 27.
You know what this does? It keeps one defense on the field. And it doesn't let them get the right personnel in there sometimes.
They're blitzing. Going.
What? Where was that going?
Incomplete pass.
Good defense and three and out series are the way to keep your defense fresh and rested.
What? The shit, like, none of the passes he throws makes any sense.
Keep the offense on the field here. Aggressive play call. Long.
What?
Incomplete.
Cleveland can't convert on fourth down. That's their third failed fourth down attempt.
The Bengals will start the drive at the 27-yard line. First and 10.
No more, fellas. Left, left, left. Don't make a play.
Closing in. Throwing.
Oh, my fucking God.
Here on the stop at the 3.
Chad Johnson enjoys playing football, and he's one of those guys who's always talking out there.
They're making some changes up front. They've had some big plays that have resulted in touchdowns, but this is their first time they've been inside the 20-yard line. Trying to get to the pylon.
And here you have the offense hold everyone up, and you just scoot around the corner and score.
Fucking meltdown. God. Fucking damn.
Graham comes in for the extra point. The point after is good. Capitalize on good field position, get it into the end zone.
Yeah, you got to convert opportunities like that into touchdowns. And that time, they did it with authority.
Going with the squib kick.
Okay.
From the 7.
Yep, good job. Fucking good. Fucking good.
The Browns have their work cut out for them as they take over at the 23. It's first and 10.
Ball on the 23-yard line.
One back.
The Browns line up in the bunch formation. Launches this one to the right. Incomplete.
Yep, he swung it downfield looking for the big play. He just had too much arm on it.
Card was the intended receiver on that play. Cincinnati comes out with 7 in the secondary. Long throw. Nearly intercepted. Deep throw, nearly picked off.
That was great defense right there. He got an excellent position, and he did everything but come away with the ball.
Them out. Under pressure, going long.
Why are those his throws?
And this should be the last play of the half.
Hey, let's go one deep. Defense, get ready.
So the punting unit stays on the sideline. They're going to take a shot here on fourth down. Throws it, and this pass is completed. Going into halftime, the score is 20.
Graham again.
Graham looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. Blue,
back to return. Ew. He can run the ball a little bit.
This one is handled by number 11.
He missed the block.
The Browns need to rebound quickly as they start this drive at the 24-yard line. With the rain and the wind, John, we talked about a low-scoring game at the outset, but it hasn't turned out that way at all.
The Browns ball on their own 24. Start the drive at the 24-yard line. First and 10.
One back.
Cincinnati goes with a four-man front. Throwing short.
Oh, and there's no way. We didn't fucking get the edge guy. I mean,
the outside has to come up and hold the play out.
Oh, shit.
The outside has to get a rush of pressure. And that was a perfect execution.
They'll go from the I formation. To carry it, runs through the tackle. Jackson is there for the tackle.
This is just the kind of thing that they have come to expect from their running game. A very consistent and effective ground attack.
The Bengals come out in a 4-3. Throwing, and it's intercepted. The 20, the 10, and they're in. Touchdown. A great return after the interception. Good blocking, and no one was able to run him down.
He didn't even get out of the right foot.
Graham comes in to attempt the point.
What the fuck was that?
Most quarterbacks in this league have short memories when it comes to interceptions. They have the confidence to keep throwing the ball. They come back and make an outstanding play.
Nice kick. Plenty of distance. From the 3.
The defense looking for a second straight interception.
Bloom on the return.
The ball on their own 27.
At the 27-yard line. First and 10.
The Bengals line up in a 4-3. With the throw, tip.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Play football! Hey, stall, stall, stall! Get it up!
Play there. Why would he not run the out? Why would he not run the out?
Pico is there on the stop. Beat the blitz, decent game.
He never seems to rush back there in the pocket. He takes his time, finds his man, and puts it right on the money.
On the 33-yard line.
Pressure, throws it.
Oh, fucking shit.
Savvy linebacker gets the turnover.
Most guys who've been around the league for a long time aren't easily fooled. When the quarterback looks them off or pump fakes, they stay in their feet, keeping their eyes on them, and then make this type of play.
Here we go.
The defense is shifting.
Let us dictate.
He hands it off. Runs him over.
Tackle.
Is there for the tackle.
A big part of this guy's running style is to use the blockers to set up his cut, but they were nowhere to be found on that run.
Cleveland comes out in their nickel pack. He takes the delayed handoff. Thompson is there on the stop at the 24. They wind up in reverse that time. Good push in the middle of the line.
Yeah, it doesn't matter who you are. If the defense gets that much penetration, you're going to go backwards.
We're turning it up.
The Browns come out in a dime package. Drops back. Pressure coming with the pass. And he, he had it and lost it. Incomplete.
The only thing he wants now is to get another chance. The coach might even want to go to him in the next play.
Kelly was his intended target. Graham will come in looking to try the field goal. The veteran connecting for the field goal.
And give credit to the kicker there. It's nice to have a guy that can make your drive worth three, even if you don't get it into the end zone every time.
Booming downfield. From the 4-yard line. The defense intercepted a pass their last time out. Ball on their own 27.
First and 10.
Rushing on first down has not worked out for them today. Less than a 2 yard per carry average.
That's why they're losing. You've got to be able to get yards on first down.
That was a good adjustment by the receiver as he reads the man coverage and finds open space.
The thing with these option routes is everyone has to make their read quickly and make their adjustments quickly. Running option routes and running them effectively.
Yeah, fullback.
A lot of repetition and practice. The defense held their positions and didn't let them get very far.
Ball right around midfield.
They ain't got nothing.
Cincinnati comes out with 8 guys in the box. Hands it off to the back. Miller is there for the tackle at the 43.
The best backs in the league average 4 to 5 yards a carry. But there are a lot of things that go into a successful running game. You got to have good play calling, good blocking up front, and a back that can take advantage when he sees the open.
With the pass. Pass ball's incomplete. Cleveland comes up short on third down, and that's been the recurring theme here today.
They're just not getting
into that's been a recurring theme,
which means that they have problems on first and second down.
They decide to keep the offense on the field. They're just out of their kicker's range. Well protected. They'll take off.
Oh, we found off court.
And after conversing with his coaches upstairs, he designed the challenge.
And I think that's the right thing to do.
And we'll take a few looks to determine whether the ball came out before the knee was down.
The key thing here is that the ball started.
Oh, I thought we had the first.
If it did, then it should be counted as a fumble.
Ball on their own 40.
Ball on the 40-yard line.
Do
Defensive line shifting around a bit. They can't get it done on the ground on first down, John, but they're still leading in this one.
Some teams manage to get by pretty well without a solid running game. And that's mostly because their passing game is very effective, especially their short passing game.
What a play by the veteran.
You know, this is one guy who has a pretty impressive list of big plays that he's made over the years.
Ball on the 43-yard line.
One of us gonna make a play.
Forced turnovers.
Cincinnati using three linebackers.
Oh, what the... Run a route.
He telegraphed that one and threw it right into the hands of the waiver.
I don't know.
So they're ready to go on offense after the interception. They'll start at the 44. Despite very little success running on first down, they still lead.
And running is important, but they've got other weapons that can get them in the end zone.
The 40, running with a lot of room in front. The 20. The 10, touchdown.
Look at the speed this guy has. But it's not all about his speed. Watch him break through a tackle and just keep going downfield. That was one hell of a run.
What the fuck?
The extra point attempt is good. So they come onto the field and get a touchdown on the first play.
That was one of those plays that an offensive coordinator dreams about. He draws it up, puts it in the playbook, tells the team to study it, and they execute it perfectly.
From the one. The defensive unit forced the interception the last time they were on the field. Has had some trouble moving the ball through the air so far. So let's turn to the chart for the story. Cincinnati using three linebackers.
I'm coming through, baby.
Going to the air on first down. Gets the pass off. The 40. Right on target to the wide receiver. The 40. The 30. Receiver running and breaks free. Touchdown, Browns.
When you get this kind of execution, you got a great chance of making a big play. Watch it here as everyone takes care of their assignment. The pass is thrown where the receiver can make the best play in the ball, and it's 6 points.
Set. Hut.
The point after is good. One play drop.
They're out there giving each other high fives and telling each other what a great job they did. And they should celebrate. That's one of the plays that doesn't happen very often.
From the 1 yard line. The defense gave up a touchdown on the last series. Ball on their own 24.
Start the drive at the 24-yard line. First and 10.
Stay at home.
Only one man back.
Oh. Where the fuck was he going?
Stopped him for his third tackle so far. Is a consistent target.
Yeah, especially in situations where they're looking to get first down yardage.
With a counter play, spins away. Number 95 is there on the stop at the 36.
The defense made that play stretch further than the runner wanted to make it.
Second and long.
The 36-yard line.
Let us dictate. Keep moving.
Be the hammer, not the nail.
Nickelback in this time to carry it. Bodden is there for the tackle at the 48. He blew right through the defense.
The offensive line dominated the defensive line there, and they sprang the runner.
Ball on the 48-yard line.
What screen?
They're making some changes up front.
Blue down, blue down. Three shoot. Watch your eyes. Let's go. Be good. Come on.
Give it to the halfback. Fumble. Loose ball. The Browns pick up the fumble.
He never had a good handle on that thing. A lot of guys would wear gloves to help him hold on to the ball. But even if you do, you still got to wrap it up and protect it. And you're going to see a lot of balls popping out like that.
Ball on the 43-yard line.
Here we go. You got to have it, D.
Dropping back to pass on first down.
Throws it. Why did he fucking? I think the fucking jump
good
button.
Play, turn bad play. Good because their zone defense worked well. Bad because he dropped the interception. That's one he wishes he could have back.
Ah.
Gets rid of it. Incomplete. And good pressure forced him to get rid of the pass early.
Any way you look at it, an incomplete pass is a heck of a lot better than throwing it to the other guy.
Ball on the 43-yard line.
Watch the ball be smart. On 28. Nothing D's.
The offense has had trouble moving the sticks on third down so far.
Big play now, big play.
Throws it. He hits his receiver. O'Neal comes up to make the play. At the 37, Harrison didn't get enough for the first. It's fourth down now, 5 yards to go. And here's how they've done so far on fourth down. They're going to go for a first down in this situation because the field goal attempt would be a very long one.
Of course. Nothing was open. They took it all away. I don't...
has been a glutton for punishment as they fail yet again to pick up a first down.
Had no answer.
The Bengals will start the drive at the 37-yard line. First and 10.
Stay both now.
Looking long down the right side of the field.
How?
Cincinnati.
I was talking to Chad Johnson the other day in practice, and he was telling me that the first thing he tries to do to get open is to make the corner think he's going to do the opposite of what he's eventually going to do.
Graham comes in for the
extra
point.
I mean, I don't fucking understand. We're not fucking covering anybody.
And, John, we were talking at the beginning about the quick strike capability. That's exactly what we were talking about. One play. One touchdown.
I'm not surprised at all by that play. You've got a chance to stick it to the other
team.
You're going to stick it to him. And that's what they did on that play.
From the 5-yard line. Number 11 returns this one to the 26.
They'll start the drive at the 26-yard line. First and 10.
Let us dictate.
They're having no success running on first down.
Stuff like a turkey. I mean, less than 2 yards isn't very good.
Williams comes up to make the play at the 42. Jurevicius makes a very difficult catch to secure the first down.
When you go up like that, coming down with it is usually not much fun, especially when you got guys nearby who are waiting to put a lick on you.
Hand it off to the back. Brown is there for the tackle at the 38-yard line. 5-yard gain.
The ball carrier. 5-yard gain on the play.
So we've reached the end of the third quarter with the Bengals ahead of the Browns. 45-10. The teams are set for the fourth quarter of play. Second and six.
Let's go. Be physical. Play football. Danny. Come on.
Cincinnati using three linebackers.
We cannot throw. I can't get the ball out there. Jesus Christ.
The 10. Touchdown, Bengals. Exactly what they had to do. Force the bad throw, get the takeaway, return it for the score.
I don't know what to fucking do. We can't throw a fucking hitch.
Graham comes in to attempt the point after. The point after is good. The Bengals have it all working now as they continue to expand their lead. As we take a look at his success returning kicks, we get ready for the kickoff.
Bloom back deep to return.
From the one.
This is one of those situations where they're playing for respect. The game really hasn't gone the way they thought it would. But they have a lot of pride in their team. Don't expect to see them keep fighting until that final whistle.
First and 10.
Cincinnati goes with a four-man front. Hand off to the tailback. Gathers is there on the stop at the 32-yard line. Lewis with a nice burst through the middle at time. 5-yard pickup. Ball on their own 32.
Gotta get the timing on the hitch better.
The Bengals with a four-man front. Closing in.
There it is. Gotta wait for the break. Throw before the break. It's a pick.
Come on. One of us gonna make a play.
Yeah, you see me.
Watch a man.
With the carry. Nice play fake. Gets the pass off.
Oh.
Flips the tackle. Picked off their opponent.
That picks today.
After the interception, they'll set up shop at the 46. Changing things up along the defensive front. Only one man in the backfield. Hand it off. Davis is there on the stop. Johnson with a nice burst through the middle that time. 5 yard pickup. It's second down and five to go.
41 yard line.
Palmer scans the defense from the gun. With the pass, he hits his receiver. Wright is there for the tackle at the 31-yard line. Ball on the 31-yard line. Cleveland comes out in their nickel package. Pass play here on first down. With the throw, runs through the tackle. Baxter comes up to make the play at the 20-yard line. They get another first down here.
Well, they're not doing anything fancy, but good old-fashioned drop back and pass. And it's working.
All on us, y'all. Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah, let's go, baby.
Give me go.
Johnson, the lone back.
Come on. My screen.
Hand it off. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss.
Johnson on the carry. 1 yard loss on the play.
Inside the red zone.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
What's the hard count? Here we go, baby, rock and roll.
Palmer with a man in motion. He hands it off. McGinnis is there for the tackle at the 17. And he picks up about 4. So a third down, they'll be looking for a play that will get them to the 10.
Hey, watch the ball. Watch the back.
Hey, let's go.
It off to the back. Washington is there on the stop at the 11. Fourth down upcoming, but they're in position to add to their lead.
Yeah, and that's what they wanted to do. Control the ball and the clock while getting into position to add at least 3 points.
About a 28-yard field goal here as they line up for the kick.
The kick is good.
The Bengals pour it on with another score. Graham is back and ready to put this one in the air.
Back deep to return.
Nice distance. This one is handled by number 11.
Kick it sure doesn't look like they're going to be able to come back in this one. But it's an issue of pride. They want to prove that they're better than they played so far.
The 2 minute warning coming up.
At the 28-yard line. First and 10.
Keep moving.
Lewis, the deep man, gets the pass off. Johnson is there for the tackle.
A successful offense is one that can run and throw for good yardage on first down.
9 yard gain.
Second and one. Ball on the 37-yard line.
Play hard and fast, baby.
Cincinnati comes out in a 46 with the throw, and he hits his target. O'Neal is there on the stop. At the 44.
Will. So we're going to take it. Great shoot.
Yes,
he'll pass on first down. Gets rid of it. Delta O'Neal was in on the play again for another tick on the stat sheet. Hayden win has been perfect on this drive.
First down on the play.
First and 10.
Ball on the 40-yard line.
Watch your man.
Let's go, D. Let's go.
The Bengals come out with eight guys in the box. Throws it. Ooh, nearly picked off. Time is working against them.
Yeah, I'm thinking they're going to keep going to the air, but it might be a little too late.
Ball on the 40-yard line.
Only one man in the backfield. With the throw, Miller is there on the stop at the 29-yard line. And it looks like they're going to go with a no huddle. Under pressure. Long throw. Almost picked off. Dropped in the end zone, so the offense still has possession.
And that's the last thing you want as a defender, to have the ball go right through your hands in the end zone.
Cincinnati using three linebackers. Dropping back, throwing.
Oh, what the? You cannot make any of the throws.
Can't bring him down.
Okay.
The veteran safety is there for the interception.
You know, there are three types of safety. Ones who play the run well, ones who play the pass well, and ones that do both well. He's a both kind of player.
Okay, baby, come on. Here we go. Watch him play.
On the call. But is there for the tackle. Gain of three. Ball on their own 39.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
Handoff to the tailback. Pope comes up to make the play. Running back finds his way into the open field and picks up the first down.
And what happened was they missed him with the blitz. And when they did that, there were no linebackers to converge. And that's how he got by the first down marker.
First and 10.
That's all.
Palmer with a man in motion.
Hand
it off to the fullback. McGinnis is there for the tackle at the 50-yard line. So a pickup of maybe three. Ball at midfield.
Ball on the 50-yard line.
Turn it up now. Strong, strong. Two backers.
Palmer sends a man in motion.
Gets
the call. Roy is there on the stop.
So, see you next time.
Wow, we got another one.
Burger, that's right. Boss, man. Burger.